Alright, time to do a chicken daily. Eh, with the bee skin, why not? So I actually just got done a few minutes ago with a speech data gathering project. So I offer no particular apologies or excuses or reasoning, I just thought I'd mention it to my audience just in case you notice something is weird. But hopefully nothing will be weird. So Chicken's a little bit of a weird character because her main ability activates when you die, and you don't want to die in this game. And it's a real penalty for dying. But you can recover when most other characters would already be dead, so that's nice. You get to get a few extra lives if you play your cards just right. But this is an action-packed game, so you certainly don't get them for free. So what would we want on a Crown of Destiny run? I've been feeling that my Crown of Destiny runs have been getting a little too samey recently. Also, I wasn't paying attention, so I just picked up took the chicken sword with me to level 2 when you're not supposed to do that. Whatever. It's fine. I don't really like the black sword that much anyway. It's okay, but it's not amazing. Frankly, usually I have a better melee weapon by then. I'd rather have a shovel, I think, than the black sword. Black sword just does not do very much damage. Right. So here's what I'm thinking. Because we were getting a little samey, we're relying a little bit too much on energy weapons, here's a very simple condition. If I see shotgun shoulders in my pre-loop mutations here, I'm gonna pick it. And we're gonna do a shotgun run today. That's what I'm feeling. So with that, either Rabbit Paw or Impact Wrist would be fine here. I think I'm gonna go with Impact Wrist, because that's gonna make shotguns a little bit better. Just because enemies will be a little bit weaker, fewer pellets, etc. And hopefully we should be getting enough ammo without it. We'll get ammo, but there's nothing that works quite like Impact Wrist, except maybe Scare Your Face. I'd say that's better. Besides, we need to play around with mutations that aren't, you know, central. They aren't, like, 100% amazing. So, I guess, we'll see. You know, maybe the game won't even give it to us, but if it does, then that's what I'm gonna do. If we see Recycle Gland, maybe I'll go with that, too, because I'd like to get at least one bullet run in here without, you know, fish or steroids or whatever, because you can do it with anybody. But, we'll see. We'll just see where the game takes us. You know, the game will give us some options, at least at first. And, we just have to see what we got. Disc Gun. Maybe better than Assault Rifle? I don't know. There's Bolt Marrow. We'll get to bolts someday. But proceeding along plan, we'll go with Plutonium Hunger. Because we're going to be up close. We're probably going to be getting our ammo anyway. But, you know what? I'm just going to do that. We need something that does actual damage. Damage like that. I believe the disc gun is automatic, but if you fire it at full automatic, you're basically asking to die by some hilarious means. I mean, you can get away with it sometimes, like I just did there, but, you know, you gotta be careful. Jackhammer. Yeah, sure, why not? We can make that work, and this is around when it would be useful. Yeah, there is some actual damage, not like that sword, that little plastic cheap toy sword we were using earlier, essentially. Must have gotten it off some kid or something. It's kind of morbid, but oh well. So here's what I'm thinking. Unfortunately, as far as shotguns go, you basically only have two deep loop options. You can either go with the Ultra Shotgun, you can go with the Super Plat Cannon, or your third option is, I don't know, you can be like fish or steroids and go with something that just shoots a whole lot. So probably like the auto flame shotgun or something. Maybe the incinerator? Well. Anyway, yeah, so those are your options. Something weird like that. Of those, probably Super Flat Cannon with triggers is the strongest, so we wanna kind of veer towards that direction. So Lucky Shot's not a bad idea. Neither is Stress. I don't think we really want Gamma Guts, because as much as we are gonna be getting into enemies' faces with shotguns, it's not all that helpful. And shotguns should be the kind of things that'll plow through things like maggots or bandits or assassins anyway. But it could be nice. I don't know, I think if we're using shotguns, we're going to want a lot of ammo. So I think Lucky Shot is going to be the thing. Because ideally with triggers, we'll be shooting fast enough that ammo will be the problem. And I don't think Stress is really going to help us too much. So I'm going to go with Lucky Shot here. And that's my reasoning. Right, so Chicken is a little bit weird because they apparently watch a lot of movies, and It's an open question why, you know, movies have survived the apocalypse, but we don't ask too many questions. And I gotta be careful because I'm already almost dead. To be fair, most people would be almost dead from being hit in the back of the head with a pipe. That is nothing to joke about. It is some pretty serious damage. But yeah, you generally get enough ammo with the jackhammer that if you don't go completely crazy with it, you'll generally be okay. Yeah, get some more explosives there. You'll generally have enough that you can just kind of click at any time you're nervous, and you'll probably delete whatever bullets were harming you, giving you problems. I can jackhammer my own disc gun. Oh man, synergies. See, look how much we're discovering just by playing around, and that was really close. Nearly died right there. Now, dying isn't the end of the world, but I still don't plan on doing it. The more I can get away without doing it, the better. So yeah, don't even need long arms with this. It works. If you're in the mood for it, just go for it. Alright, so what else? Oh, yeah, the other thing with jackhammers, I gotta be a little bit careful of the IDPD grenades like I was with that energy screwdriver. And the disc gun does hit multiple times, but it's still kind of weak damage. I definitely don't want to be relying on this by the time I'm in Palace. How do you get those bank shots? Pop rifle. Not the kind of upgrade I was looking for there. I was looking for a little bit better of a weapon by Big Dog. This will work. I guess I'm going to go in here and take Crown of Curses. Why not? There's that trigger fingers I was looking for. Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead, tell me more. Right, and throwing. That's kind of like a... I mean, really, it's an interesting ability, but it's not really super useful. It's kind of like a last-ditch effort. That's better than nothing, though. Now, the nice thing is I can kind of jackhammer these guys with impunity, because they don't throw grenades. The one nice thing about shielders, they don't have grenades. All the other ones do. Yep. Disc gun is actually pretty nice for the Big Dog fight, actually, because not only does it carve through Big Dog and hit him multiple times, but it also goes right through him and you can hit, you know, the infamous snipers on the other side of Big Dog. You know, it'll just go right through them and kill the snipers. It's great. Still gotta be a little careful with it, but, you know, it works. Just for now, but I'm still definitely looking for something better. That is our cursed chest. Seeker pistol. I think I'm gonna go for it. Let's be exciting. Let's go to the cursed crystal caves with no strong spirit on it daily. What could go wrong? A lot of things could go wrong. These things could instantly kill me. Well, let's see if I regret this. Yeah, see, that I was that close to dying already. So last time with melting didn't go so well. I think it was melting anyway. This is a little bit better of a weapon set. The jackhammer isn't great, because obviously I don't want to be close to anything in here. Both the crystals and the regular spiders, as we've seen. So really, I kind of wish I had like a double shotgun in here instead of the jackhammer. That would be a lot better. But at least the weapons I do have are reasonably efficient, so it's not so bad. I can kind of abuse the jackhammer a little bit to shoot through walls. Pretty sure those things can't teleport around corners. I think they're only allowed to teleport in straight lines. Don't quote me on that, though. And plus, this thing does at least have area of effect, so if they split once, it does hit all the spiders as they do split. So, there's something, at least. Yeah, let's get in there and shoot this some more. This thing does benefit quite a bit from the old trigger fingers. Not really what we're after here. Super Bazooka's not bad, but not really appropriate for the current scenario, I think. Lightning Pistol is okay. I think I still want to stick with Secret Pistol, though. If I have the choice. Yeah, just play this nice and slow. But hey, we're getting lots of rads here. That's why you want to come here. Just everything is so hyper-radioactive, it's kind of ridiculous. Okay, Nuts of these webs, I have a better idea. Alright, let's back up. Make sure the path's clear. Let's get ourselves some, a little bit more breathing room, how about. You know, sometimes you just need to do a little remodeling. But yeah, now you got some actual, you know, breathing room to actually walk around on solid ground with. There is, still more down there. That's not what I want to see. Alright, let's try it again, shall about. There we go. That's how you deal with the cursed crystal caves. Just blow them the heck up. Alright. Probably strong spirit here. Still really helpful for not taking extra life when you would have died. So that's pretty good. And there's a shotgun shoulders. Okay. Don't you just love it when the parts of a plan actually start falling into place? This is a little rough. Let's make sure nobody gets any clever ideas here. Just gotta clear this out a little bit. And get in there and get the ammo, of course. Sometimes you just really gotta, you know, even when you're pinned down like this, you gotta, you know, sneak out, get some ammo, go back. Alright. That could have been a little rough, but, you know, because we were proactive about it, we got out of it okay. Alright, this is probably worth checking. Minigun. Yeah, I'll take that. Probably a little bit better than the secret pistol. Not, like, a lot better. We're not really built for it, but it'll work. And as it was full up on ammo, too. Can't completely disregard that, although ideally you would want to. But yeah, this is not really focused damage, because you really gotta hold the button down for tanky targets like that, and regular old tanks are not even particularly tanky compared to other things we're gonna be fighting, like, I don't know, gold tanks, and the palace dogs. But we'll get there. It's better than the secret pistol, I think, just because you can just sustain all that fire. I gotta find this old, this crown vault. Okay, it's down there. Open that up. Come on. Come on, open. There we go. Whoop. Yep. So you gotta be careful of that. That's exactly what I was warning myself about, and here we are. Okay. Everything's fine. We're okay. You know, you can get yourself out of some pretty tight spots with this kind of thing. And that is a non-cursed blood cannon. It's gonna do more damage than the, than that. So yeah, I'll pick it up. It's useful. We'll make it work for us. Okay. Maybe rhino skin? The nice thing about rhino skin on, chicken is that you lose 2 HP every time you die and come back to life. So essentially, rhino skin makes it both less likely that you die in the first place, and when you come back to life, you have more max HP remaining. So in principle, you can die more times before you finally go to, you know, zero max health and you just die no matter what. So that makes it even better on chicken than already is. So probably rhino skin here, then Crown of Destiny will give me back muscle, which is fine on a shotgun build. And we'll see from there. Sounds good to me. Just gotta be a little bit careful with the blood cannon, because it does take a decent amount of ammo. But, we'll get there. A direct hit with it does okay damage. It's not really super impressive, but it's alright. Okay, Crown of Destiny. Let's go. Destiny. Back muscle, as promised. And we'll get one more. I gotta be careful with the blood cannon as well, because, like the other one, that will blow up the, grenades. But fortunately, this will help get rid of, Little Hunter's bullets. Now, the thing that's a little bit weird about the old, the blood cannon is if you fire when you're too close to a wall, it will just blow up, like, on the wall behind you. Now, occasionally that's helpful, like, if you're pinned down by bullets, you fire it right here. Well, it kind of depends on the angle. I mean, obviously you can kind of just face the wall and make sure it blows up there, too. Heavy machine gun is probably not what we want right now. I wish the heavy series of bullet weapons were just a little bit better. I saw that gold tank up there. That's something to be a little worried about. I'm just gonna clear out some space down here so I have more space to fight it. And my weapons are fine for now. I'll get a few more chances for, I'll get, like, a couple more. Nah. I think since we've only got two levels left before Palace, I'll go ahead and check that. Gatling Bazooka. I wish I had Boiling Veins. I'd probably take it. It's gonna do a lot more damage in this Blood Cannon, but I don't really trust myself without it. It's a fine weapon, and it does work. It's just, man, it's dangerous for a reason. Like, that is the one weapon you will probably blow yourself up with. You can practice proper trigger discipline with the nuke launcher and the super bazooka, but the Gatling Bazooka is definitely a fire, like, auto-fire weapon, and you will blow yourself up by being irresponsible with it if you're not careful. Need a little bit of the AoE here, but we'll get through this. Plasma Cannon, yes, a lot better than the Blood Cannon. Doesn't delete bullets, but, you know, it's gonna actually kill some stuff, and we need to get rid of these, Necromancers ASAP, or else we're gonna have some problems. Don't want, we're not in loop yet, it's not supposed to be this messy. Yeah, I'll tell you what we're missing, is Bloodlust. Yeah, we need some of that. Yeah, but back muscle will be okay. It's not amazing, but it does help. There's certainly a lot of mutations that are worse than that. And just being able to carry more ammo and, you know, in those situations where you're low on ammo and get a ton of ammo, you can fill all the way up to full, and that's nice. Sharp teeth is really not what we're looking for, but, so be it. Yeah, sometimes that's just the best option. Take advantage of the old grace period and just run right up to them and point blank shoot them. It's risky, but it works, and even if they do shoot you, it's usually only for 3 damage, so it's usually not that bad. So we're already not, like, perfectly well set, but we have trigger fingers in the plasma cannon, so we can get away with a lot. We're looking for something a little bit better than the minigun, but minigun, plasma cannon, we can go pretty far with that, at least through loop 1. I don't know about loop 2, but, well, I don't know, I guess the sky's the limit. I'll skip that weapons chest. We clearly handled the palace alright, so we can skip this one too. Get something good on loot. We'll be okay. So, yeah, we're looking for the super flat cannon. That is not the super flat cannon, but it's only an normal flamethrower. Too bad. Wave gun. Might not be powerful enough. It's not bad, but I think we're past the point where it would be help. I think the minigun is going to be better than that, just because of the rate of fire. I mean, I'll fire just, like, a couple of times, just for, you know, gotta show it off a little, but, unfortunately, the, damage leaves something to be desired. So, we'll see. There will be others. There will be replacements. Well, I guess we're not skipping that one after all. Oh well. Alright, harder to kill. Not as good. Like, I find I want to take that with Bloodlust. Otherwise, I actually usually go for the teleporting weapons one, because that makes the throwing option a lot better. But it's okay. In principle, neither one of those should actually matter, because you won't be using them. That's the kind of ultras we have to work with here. But hey, ultra before the throne, that's pretty nice. Alright, so all that remains to be seen is seeing how good shotguns weapon are on loop. Sadly, they kinda aren't, but we'll work with it. We'll get somewhere no matter what we end up working with here. So, once you get to loop, throwing weapons is mostly kind of a stopgap measure when you're already in, like, cover and safe. You don't really have time when you're out in the open to be just spamming your weapon, throwing willy-nilly and, like, picking up other weapons and just kind of chucking them all over the place. Even with the, like, thrown butt determination combo, that does some pretty good damage. That's, like, it's kind of like having, like, an auto crossbow and a half with, like, 2 ammo. And it's really slow. But, you can get some nice burst damage on a boss when you're, like, running away into cover. So it's all right, but generally, like, you want to just have enough ammo to just manage a situation without having to do that. Still, it can solve some of your ammo problems. Alright, Lucky Shot should be pretty good. People don't like Lucky Shot, but it scales in loop. It's not bad. You know, and it's automatic weapon. It's ammo that's just given to you that you don't have to pick up, so it's kind of like Bloodlust. It's just not nearly as efficient as Bloodlust is. But even then, like, a bootleg Bloodlust is still pretty nice. There's a heck of a lot of stuff down there, so let's just fire 6 plasma cannon shots down there. Why not? That's starting to seem like a pretty good idea. Took care of that elite grunt pretty nicely. So yeah, we're fairly powerful. We're not amazingly powerful, but we got some firepower under our belt here. Not even a Gatling Slugger, just a regular Slugger. Super Crossbow. Could go Super Crossbow. I don't know. Minigun's doing alright, at least for now. It'll be nice in the desert and the sewers and to a certain extent the scrapyard. And by then, we should probably have better weapons. I'd go Super Crossbow Plasma Cannon in the Frozen City. And we'll probably have a chance for something similar to that by the time we get there. Super Slugger, that's an option. Not amazing, because it just isn't very efficient, doesn't pierce. But, worth thinking about, at least. Where's the, Crown Ball? Not here. Gotta make sure we don't get blown up here. Just wave that thing around. Should be more dead. There you go. Alright, there we go. Minigun, very nice for activating that thing without blowing it up. There we go. Where are you going? Whoops. Uh-oh. So now I have a repeat from last time. Where'd you go? There we go. Sometimes you just want to use this thing and stand back and... Whoops. Well, I just right-clicked and threw my minigun. Thankfully, it went into the portal, so no big deal. But, it's the kind of thing that can get to you if you're not careful. Probably not really anything we want here. I'll take this and then put bullets in it. There we go. Oh, I can't get rid of it. Or yes, I can. Do I want to store a golden assault rifle? I forget what this is a metagame thing now. I literally forget what weapon I have stored on Chicken. I think it's like a golden wrench or something. Golden assault rifle's not bad, though. But I don't really care for it. Yeah, so let's not ruin that. That's actual, like, out-of-game effort on a daily, which is a little bit weird. Doesn't come up all that often. Anyway, the minigun should be waiting for us right here, as it is. Very good. And let's get that Crown of Destiny off and that Crown of Blood on, and let's get the game started for real. Yeah, so general rule of thumb when you have back muscle is use any of your weapons. If you have over, like, your natural ammo cap on these, like, over 55 energy, just shoot the plasma cannon until you're down below 50. Doesn't even matter if you hit anything. You'll probably will by accident. Just keep shooting it. Same goes with the minigun. Because, you know, obviously you weren't low on ammo before then, so you won't be low on ammo after then. Alright, we need to fire a whole bunch of these in here. Which we did, thanks to Trigger Fingers. You know, a whole bunch of things were dying out there in the main level, which gave us constant Trigger Fingers procs on the old plasma can, so I fired like 12 of those into the big bandits. You know, there's a reason Trigger Fingers is one of the best mutations in the game. I'm not sure, it's probably the best. Maybe... I think it's better than long arms. I'd rather have trigger fingers and no long arms than long arms with no trigger fingers. I think it's that good. You can make it work without it. That's what I'm, like, part of what I'm going for with this series. Hyper Slugger. You know, you can do stuff like this, but it's not really that exciting. It's not bad, but I don't think it's really what we're building for here. Because it just doesn't have the rate of fire and the damage that we're looking for. So we're really looking for, like, a... I don't think it's going to be better for us than the minigun, is what I'm saying. It's not bad. For single target damage, it's amazing as a boss killer weapon, but we already have one in the form of the plasma cannon. So really, we just don't need it. I'm not sure I'd drop the super, whoops. Gotta be careful of that. I'm not sure I'd drop the minigun for the super flat cannon. Would I go super flat cannon and regular plasma cannon? I'm not sure. I don't think I'd drop the super regular plasma cannon for the super flat cannon, though. Plasma cannon is just too good of a weapon. And, unfortunately, sharp teeth is just kind of a stinker here. Like, I take some damage, it gets multiplied by 2, it's still not that impressive, though. So I gotta get my bearings here and figure out where enemies are. Alright, well, there's a double minigun. That's probably an improvement, because I've got the back muscle. So I'll, you know, as soon as I can actually get to it, I will. Whoops. That one trailing, let's not get nicked here for all our life. Alright, there we go. Carve through that stuff. Oop. Back up. There we go. Fit through that. Alright, everything's fine. Just gotta keep playing till everything's fine. Then everything will be fine. That's it. Alright, so double minigun. There's an appreciable improvement to our, to our damage per second. I heard that... I don't remember where I heard this, but apparently it was supposed to be a joke weapon. Like, it wasn't meant to be serious. Like, you were supposed to just run out of ammo instantly with it. But it turns out it's actually just a good weapon, because you kill things faster, you run low on ammo, more bullets drop, and you fill back up, and it's good. You just have to be a little careful with it, that you don't miss too much. Obviously, Recycle Gland makes it a lot better, although the inaccuracy on it makes it a little bit unreliable, but... You know, it's... when you just need to run right up to something and stick it in something's chest, it's great. Alright, and we're dead. Oh, but we're alive, so everything's fine. Just took that plasma ball to the face, but we're okay. So Rhino Skin there is working in our favor, because we still have, or we used to have... we need some... Alright. That can be a problem now, won't it? Oh well, that's what I get for not paying attention, Yeah, I'm gonna have to review the footage to see what happened there. I think I, like, backed up and then, like, walked right back in it, but clearly I just didn't even see it was there or something. So yeah, these guys are dangerous. Gotta actually see them. And actually seeing things can be hard in loop sometimes, because it all just kind of blends together. Oh well, not too bad, though. Still some room for improvement, obviously, but, you know, you can get away with doing almost whatever. That's kind of what I'm getting at here. But hey, you know, I'm hoping we can see some more of the double minigun when the time is right. But, and Shotgun Shoulders will get its time in the sun, too. We're just not quite there yet.